This video is brought to you by Virchi, a science and technology company offering research and development and consulting. The expanding Earth and continental plates movement. Earth is in constant movement through space and is always absorbing energy from the sun and the ether or dark matter from outer space. Earth moves in the solar system. The solar system moves in the Milky Way galaxy, and the galaxy moves in the universe. The following are the factors for the continent's movement, separation, and expansion. Number 1, the electromagnetic energy coming from the sun. The electromagnetic energy / current from the sun interacts with the inner solid core to create the electromagnetic induction effect, the magnetosphere, and the spin force, also known as the homopolar generator effect, in conjunction with the moon. This causes friction between the inner solid core and outer solid mantle or crust, and is a factor in creating the lava region. Number 2, the constant supply of the building blocks of matter. Atomic matter is composed of subatomic matter, also known as the ether / dark matter, etc. The subatomic energy, the ether, dark matter, or subatomic matter, coming in through the poles from outer space, into the inner core, and into the inner earth layers. The molten lava region is constantly supplied by the subatomic building blocks of matter. The ether / dark matter / subatomic matter keeps the lava region increasing in volume and expanding by generating more molten mass. This supply of energy keeps the lava region in constant mass volume growth. This constant growth of the lava region mass causes an outward push force of expansion on the crust / mantle of the planet. Number 3, the solid inner core expansion. The inner core spins at a higher rate than the shell / mantle due to the Faraday homopolar generator effect on the structure of the planet. Details on the homopolar generator effect are in the first episode of this series and will be linked in the description. The inner solid core goes through an inflation and expansion effect due to the centrifugal force of spin. The inflation / expansion of the inner solid core is a very slow gradual process. As the inner solid core is enlarged, it pushes outward on the outer layers, the lava area, and the shell or mantle. The outward push force coming from the inside of the planet through the inner core and lava region causes the outer shell or mantle to enlarge and expand, causing the continents to constantly separate from each other. Number 4, the constant growth compounding of solid rock / crystals and organic matter. Organic matter is in constant growth, death, and rebirth. It has a slow but constant accumulative effect on the surface areas of the planet. Crystal matrix formation. Many forms of rocks and crystals grow and expand at a very slow rate. These factors on a time frame of millions of years are also a cause of crust / mantle growth. The combination of the four previous factors is what causes Earth to constantly expand, grow, and increase in size and diameter. The continental movement needs to factor in the kinetic force of Earth's spin on the surface of the planet, the surface wind and currents, and the drag effect on the surface of Earth. As an example of expansion, if a balloon was inflated to 30 centimeter diameter, then painted over with a thick layer of mud and left to dry, and if we were to then further inflate the balloon to grow by a few centimeters in diameter, we would observe portions of the mud surface areas splitting and separating from each other, as do the continents on Earth's surface. The Pangaea theory. The Pangaea theory consists of a hypothesis of a supercontinent that existed during the late Paleozoic and early Mesozoic eras. It assembled from earlier continental units approximately 335 million years ago, and it began to break apart about 175 million years ago. In contrast to the present Earth and its distribution of continental mass, much of Pangaea was in the southern hemisphere and surrounded by a super ocean, the Panthalassa, Pangaea was the most recent supercontinent to have existed and the first to be reconstructed by geologists. The Pangaea theory is half correct. The fact that all continents fit together like a puzzle is 100% correct. However, this theory gets it wrong by not realizing that this is due to an expanding slash enlarging Earth, and not surface continental movement only. Dark matter and ether absorption. This process of the dark matter slash ether, also known as subatomic matter, being pulled in through the poles and penetrating into the inner layers of the planet, interacts with the lava in the outer layers of Earth, aided by the electromagnetic induction effect of the inner core's out-of-sync spin with the outer shell and crust. This has an energy supply effect of supplying energetic fuel for the deep Earth lava and matter to grow. These are the main factors for Earth's continuous growth and continental expansion. Earth, and possibly other planets, is like an organism in constant growth, always increasing in size due to the following three factors. 1. The electric or electromagnetic currents, radiation heat, and energy from the sun. 2. The unlimited supply of the subatomic building blocks of matter, ether, dark matter, subatomic matter from outer space. 3. Constant motion slash movement of all celestial bodies throughout the universe. These three forces are the building blocks of life in the universe. Expanding Earth and growing Earth history. Many prominent scientists in past history supported the expanding Earth mass theory. In 1834, during Charles Darwin's second voyage of HMS Beagle, Darwin investigated the stepped plains featuring raised beaches in Patagonia, Argentina, which indicated to him that a huge area of South America had been uplifted to its present height by a succession of elevations, which acted over the whole of this space with nearly an equal force. While his mentor, Charles Lyell, had suggested forces acting near the crust on smaller areas, Darwin hypothesized that an uplift of this continental scale required the gradual expansion of some central mass, acting by intervals on the outer crust, with the elevations being concentric with the form of a globe, or certainly nearly so. In 1835, he extended this concept to include the Andes as part of a curved enlargement of the Earth's crust due to the action of one connected force. Not long afterwards, he moved on from this idea and proposed that as mountains rose, the ocean floors subsided, explaining the formation of coral reefs. In 1889 and 1909, Roberto Mantovani published a hypothesis of Earth's expansion and continental drift. He assumed that a closed continent covered the entire surface of a smaller Earth. Thermal expansion led to volcanic activity, which broke the land mass into smaller continents. These continents drifted away from each other because of further expansion at the rip zones, where oceans currently lie, although Alfred Wegener noticed some similarities to his own hypothesis of continental drift. He did not mention the expansion of Earth as the cause of drift in Mantovani's hypothesis. A compromise between Earth expansion and Earth contraction is the theory of thermal cycles by Irish physicist John Joly. He assumed that heat flow from radioactive decay inside Earth surpasses the cooling of Earth's exterior. Together with British geologist Arthur Holmes, Joly proposed that a hypothesis in which Earth loses its heat by cyclic periods of expansion. In their hypothesis, expansion led to cracks and joints in Earth's interior that could fill with magma. This was followed by a cooling phase where the magma would freeze and become solid rock again, causing Earth to shrink. In 1888, scientists Ivan Ospovich Yarkovsky suggested that some sort of ether is absorbed within Earth and transformed into new chemical elements, forcing the celestial bodies to expand. This was connected with his mechanical explanation of gravitation. Also, The thesis of Otto Christoph Hilgenberg and Nikola Tesla were based on absorption and transformation of ether energy into normal matter. After initially supporting continental drift, the late Australian geologist Samuel Warren Carey advocated expansion from the 1950s. Samuel Warren Carey was an Australian geologist and a professor at the University of Tasmania. He was an early advocate of the theory of continental drift. His work on plate tectonics reconstructions led him to develop the expanding Earth hypothesis. Although the expanding Earth hypothesis is nearly universally rejected by geoscientists, it has been defended recently based on detailed small Earth modeling by Klaus Vogel and James Maxlow, and by many others worldwide based on other relevant data. This video is pulled from chapters from the Dinosaur Bonsai Apocalypse and the Magnetic Pole Shift books, all of which will be available on Amazon, Apple eBooks, and Barnes & Noble. Links will be in the description.